evening. How are you? How are you doing? This is Abefe Badeara, the real Coco Mistress. How are we today? How is it all going? Are we all here today? What's happening at Technica? It's Technica. Technica, okay. Okay, how are you? Good evening. Yeah, welcome to another episode of The Real Coco. How are you? Hope you enjoyed yourself last week with this Van Vicar. How's your own Van Vicar? Have you got your Van Vicar yet? I didn't promote last week that you should go and buy dildo and be all this press. Well, I didn't say that too. So I hope none of you got me wrong, because a guy called me and said, Abefe, please, do you have something that I can use to make it bigger? No, I don't. I used to sell Paraga, but my Paraga won't make it bigger. It will only give you stamina, no more than that. So I don't sell extension, no. But if you want extension cable for your phone, for your iPad, I can get it for you. But extension to make your cocoa long, no. And some ladies asked about Aboniki and Rob. I don't supply those, but I'm sorry. Anyway, cocoa for today. It's about married but living single. You're married but you're living like a single person. I thought about this about an hour ago, and which is so silly really, because I didn't really prepare anything, you know, just noted some few things and whatever, you know. But are you married but living as if you're a single person? Or are you cohabiting? Because in UK here, we're very good at cohabitation, you know. We cohabit with each other, mesmerize, just keep the cocoing going. I know a couple, I think I posted about something, was it a couple of months ago, about a lady, she's been living with her partner for over almost 20 years, and they're not married. So the topic today is about whether you're married or not, but you are cohabiting, you're living with your partner, but you still feel as if you're single. Is that happening to you? Are you married, but you don't feel like you're with someone, like you don't feel like a married woman or married man? You still feel like, you know, I'm still single, I can still do whatever I want or whatever. Yeah? Number three. Are you the only one maintaining the house, I mean your household, your marriage, despite your husband or wife working? Because that's one of the things that can make somebody to feel single as well, even though they're married or living with a partner. Yeah? Another question as well is, what should a married home feel like? I'm married, I'm at home with my husband, with my wife. You know, what sort of expectations do you have of, okay, if you're single, you're watching this, right? I know you have in your brain how a married home should be like or will be like. You understand what I'm saying? What are your thoughts about when you get married, how your home is going to be like? Have you ever thought about that? You can chip in at any time, or if you're watching, if you want to say anything, 0203-355-5526, yeah? 0203-355-5526. And if you're calling from abroad, remember to add +44. Are you married or living with a partner, but you still think, or the whole thing feel as if you're single? Throughout this week, I've been talking to a lot of ladies, few men, and they complain. It's like, you know, oh, have a fair. I just feel as if I'm still single. I don't feel, you know, like as if I'm married or whatever. You know, they're just saying the same thing. Everybody. So obviously there's a problem either in the society, in the community, in the hair somewhere that's making people to feel like that. Because when I was married, I didn't feel single at all. Well, maybe towards the end tail of the marriage, probably about 6 months towards the end of the marriage, you know, I felt like, oh, there's something wrong here, you know. I felt it and I discussed it with my husband that, look, this thing is not going well. Should we just go each other's way? Because we just go each other's ways and everybody just go, because I want to feel like I'm married, I'm with my man, it's all well and good, it's all lovely, rosy. My kids, I want them to feel like they're in a happy home, we're doing things together. That's what I want. So if you're that sort of person, if you're a person that you're married or living with a partner but still feel like a single person, please call in, tell me about it. Let's talk it together. One of the things people, you know, that they made mention to me about feeling single despite being married is they said, I have a family, I'm the only one paying the bills. He doesn't ask about the kids. All we do together is just at night time, open your legs, bang, bang, bang. Banging, start. Finish. They don't talk. It will be downstairs. She'll be upstairs. She will be upstairs. It will be downstairs. She's on the phone talking to her friends. He's on the phone. He's on the computer. You know, they're not doing things together. And that's what many ladies have told me throughout this week. And I'm thinking, what are you still doing there? I would have gone nuts. Knowing me, I would have screamed. Like, in fact, knowing me or me personally, I befell, that man will know that somebody is living in the house. Because you have to talk to me now. What are we doing together if you're not talking to me? What are we doing? You must communicate with me every day. You come back from work, you must gist me. What happened at work? The client you see and saw, what you had for lunch. You cannot do that, I beg, forget. So when people tell me that they feel single whilst married, I can't get my head around it. I find it strange, because what are you still doing there? Please, I'm not saying divorce your husband or your wife. I'm not saying that. Or move out, or go each other's ways. But I think it's a problem. And during the week, I wanted to post about something called Marriage Converter. Yes. It's a... it's Abefe that's going to come up with that thing, Marriage Converter. That you convert your marriage from Nigerian thing, marriage, whatever, to European style or westernized style or whatever. The reason why I thought of that was that I thought to myself, many ladies would say, it doesn't take me to the cinema, we don't go out together. And I thought, it doesn't take you to the cinema. How many cinemas do we have in Nigeria? Excuse me? I don't remember going to a cinema in Nigeria. Maybe now they've got a blue board, a black board, or be something bird. Somewhere in Lekki and another one, I don't know. But I didn't, you know, I can't remember going to the cinema whilst living in Nigeria or whatever. Even up until 5-10 years ago, I can't remember any cinemas being in Nigeria. And in Nigeria, they said they don't go clubbing together, partying. Excuse me? In Nigeria, clubs are meant for, as far as they're concerned, I shall always go to clubs. And silly girls, wayward girls. So the men will always say, it's not for married women. So you need marriage converter in order for you to be able to have all these things in your relationship if you're feeling single. So if you want the converter, let me know. I sell the converter. I will sell it to you, and you'll be able to plug it on your partner, and they will do. Why are you looking at me like that? It is you, Mr. Michael. Yes, I sell it. If you want to buy marriage converter, so you can convert your Nigerian man to being Western man. That way, it will be taking you to the cinema, clubbing, dinner, and everything will be fine. But come on, let's come off it. You're trying to convert your relationship to what it is not. What you didn't start with is not gonna work. And that is why you will forever be feeling single in your relationship. When you met your partner, you didn't start going to the cinema every week or once a month or whatever. You didn't start it like that. So why do you want it now? So all you're trying to do is to convert that relationship to being something else that you did not start with. You're not used to kissing your partner. You're used to him getting to the bedroom. You know, you got your nightie on, and next minute, another Nigerian, they use their fingers more. You know, back in Nigeria, no all this licking and sucking. It's always finger, you know? So your man, stop looking at me like you're licking. Mr. Michael, you're making me laugh. Am I saying something wrong? Just correct me if I'm saying something wrong. In Nigeria, where we come from, men in those days don't suck and lick the finger. True or false, my producer? You don't know, because you used to do that. He said yes. He said true. So now you're now abroad, or we're now more westernized in Nigeria, even still living in Nigeria, and you're not like, you want to change that relationship, you want him to do this to you, do that to you. Obviously, you're trying to convert that relationship to be what it is not. So automatically, you will feel single in that relationship, because what you want is not going to give it to you. Another one is to do with finances and a house, right? I got that wrong in my marriage. So I know what many women that are married or cohabiting, what they're going through. They always complain this. Oh, yes, I'm the only one paying bills, doing bills, paying that, doing shopping. Yes, because you started it like that. In the beginning, your man is used to you going shopping, doing the groceries without you asking him. Annoying some men, they're very lazy. If you don't ask, they will not do. And the moment you start asking, they will tell you are nagging. So automatically, he's used to it. He's not going to come, you know. And 2, 3, 4 years down the line, you want to change him. And start saying, hey, my friend's husband is the one doing this, is the one doing that. It's not going to work. So you will need this converter. I've got this converter if you want it. Do we have a caller? No?
Hello?
As I can see. Do you have a caller online? Hello, caller. What's your name? Where are you calling from?
Hello, this is Ronnie. I'm calling from France.
Oh, I can't hear. Producer, can you raise it up a little bit, please? Hello?
Hi, it's okay. I'm calling from France.
You're calling from France?
Yeah.
Hello, how are you?
I'm fine.
Oh, fantastic. We got a caller from France. Yes. What do you have to contribute today?
Yeah, you were saying something about going for shopping and doing all the...
Yes.
All the bills. Normally, it's right for a man. In the sense that the normal thing must be done as in the man should take care of you.
Yes.
In the room.
Yes.
Even if the woman wants to go shopping, the man is meant to drop money up.
Yes.
You don't need to have.
Yeah.
The woman is not meant to ask. And
yeah, you're right. She's not meant to ask. Yes.
It's supposed to be a normal thing. Normal thing.
Yeah.
You know, I think Niger men are different from men in Niger.
Yeah.
Men living in Nigeria and men living in Africa are quite different people.
Yeah. Okay. But what do you think? Should that be enough reason for you to be married and be feeling single?
Not really. So.
Because some people say, okay, they're the one looking, taking care of the bills, but they feel single that because the man is not contributing. Can that make someone feel single?
No.
No. Are you married?
Yes.
You are married? Okay, so you feel like a married woman in your relationship?
Yes, I am.
And how's the contribution in the house? Is your husband next to you? Okay, tell me lies. Eh? Tell me lies. It's next to you. Tell me lies.
I can't hear you.
I said, tell me lies. If it's next to you, tell me lies. If it's not next to you, tell me the truth.
No, I'm not 50-50.
50-50?
Yeah.
Okay, and that makes you feel like everything is okay,
comfortable.
Like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And someone taking the whole deal. If the woman is, she won't be comfortable out.
Yeah.
And okay. You feel all the things on your head.
Yes. Then you.
What
then
the man thing. But when you do 50-50, you'll be on a safer side.
You'll be on a safer side. Right. But you know in Nigeria, they don't do this 50-50 syndrome.
That's in Nigeria. That's why I said, man in Nigeria are quite different. A man in Nigeria is of the home. He will pay all the bills, he has rent.
Yeah.
You are working as a woman, as a mother. They won't give you money for shopping.
Yes.
But here in Europe, that it's quite different. I mean, both of you go to work.
Yeah.
You come back home. Now you analyze the. Okay, I'm going to pay this. I'm going to pay.
Right.
I'm going to pay for. Okay, I'm going to take this responsibility for the kids. Okay, so you take one. But it's not like that in Nigeria. No way.
Yeah. So what about looking after the kids? Who will look after the kids then? If you're doing it 50-50?
It's the mother. I'm the one.
Yeah, the one. But you don't work full-time, or you don't work full-time?
4 days.
4 days? Huh. It's still full-time now with kids. How many kids do you have? Sorry.
I have two.
Two? Chineke, me. Yeah. God is your strength. I hope they're not babies, though. Because even my own, that they're big, is still headache for me.
Them. 6 years and two.
6 years and two. Oh my God. The two, not a girl.
No, it's a boy.
It's a boy. Oh my days. Oh, you've got it. You've got your hands full. Thank you so much, sis, for calling
Thank
in.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Because I normally go to your work.
Oh,
so
gosh.
I'm on Facebook every day.
Oh my God.
My
Thank
husband
you.
Is always complaining. This is
You see, when your husband complains next time, tell him that my name is Abefe Abedo and I'm ready to bear those. Yeah? Thank you so much. Talk to you again soon. Thank you. All right then. Bye-bye.
Yeah, bye.
Wow. Lovely call. You know, that's another point. That's what I was just talking about men in Europe and men in Nigeria. The way we're brought up is completely different to the way we see things and the way things are now in the world. The way things are is completely different. It is different. So this converter is, you. If you need it, just let me know. I keep telling you, you need this converter. It is only this converter that will work in your relationship. If you want your man or your woman to start behaving one kind, just tell me. I will send it to you. You understand? But you pay for package and postage. Yeah? Packaging and postaging, you must pay. Married but living single. Okay, the lady said 50-50. There was a day we discussed bills. We talked about bills as well. And someone said 50-50. Some people say 80-20. And there was a lady called Bola. I cannot forget that lady. She said as 100%. 100 to 0. Husband doing everything. In fact, a jealous and jealous of that lady. Because I wish I can be in her shoes. You know. But because you're paying all the bills, should that make you feel like a single person? What about if, you know, the other way around, if it's the other way around and it's the man paying all the bills? What about if it's the man paying all the bills? Is it going to make him feel single, like he's married but still feeling like a single person? Is that going to be like that? Will he still feel single? Do we have a caller? No. Right. Or you working full time and your husband is not working full time, why should that make you feel like a single person? I think many women feel like that because majority of our men, or don't let me use the majority, because by the time I get on my wall now, we see the men there, they would have posted, Abefe, you're too biased. You're always just, you're complaining about men. Okay, many of our men, right, they're not so affectionate, they don't show affection, you know, they don't they don't cuddle, they don't kiss that much, you know, they don't do all this lovey-dovey and whatever in the house. So automatically a woman will feel single. She'll feel like she's married but single. Yes. Like the lady said, that is not good enough reason. You pay, you being the only one paying the bills, shouldn't make you feel like a single person. But what makes many of the women feel like a single person, they're the only one paying the bills, they're the only one doing the washing, the only one tidying up the house, the only one looking after the kids, and there's this man there eating all the food, and you see enjoyment. If you've not cooked pounded yam with a 4-year-old or a la sepo, now lie. We've got a caller online. What's your name and where you calling from, please? Hello?
Hi, hello.
Hello, good evening.
My name is Chocolate. I'm from Canada.
Your name is what?
Chocolate, I'm calling from Canada.
Hello, Sister Chocolate from Canada. How are you?
I'm doing good.
Thank God. What have you got to add?
Yeah, I just have a question.
Yeah?
Is it appropriate for a mom with 2 kids to take care of people?
To be what?
Is it appropriate for a woman with kids to ask for upkeep from a husband with other?
To be asking for money for upkeep from the partner?
Yes.
Right. I can hear myself. I think you've got the thing on, either your computer or something. Can you lower the volume on it, please?
Okay, that's
okay. Okay, right. Well, you shouldn't have to ask your man for money for upkeep. You shouldn't have to. If you get into a stage that you're asking your partner for money for upkeep, then the man is getting to a level that is becoming irresponsible.
Mm-hmm.
A reasonable man should know, even if he's got very little, right? This is where women's whatever comes into play, right? You know your partner is making lesser money than you are. But a reasonable man will say, sweetheart, take this for the upkeep of the house. You understand what I'm saying? But it is not for the woman to start asking, Baba Lagbaja, bring money, we're going to buy this, bring money.
No, they're not living together. The lady is somewhere else, the husband is in Nigeria, but the husband is working and earning money. But the lady has been abroad.
Okay, the lady is abroad, the man is in Nigeria.
Yes.
Right, even wherever he is in the world, he should still be able to send money. I know men, actually, that was the first guy a lady very close to me, her husband sent her money from Nigeria every month. I was shocked that the man was sending £300 every month, even though it didn't cover the rent or whatever, but it was still something. You understand what mm-hmm. I'm saying? Wherever a man is in the world, that should not determine his responsibilities. That should not determine whether he should be responsible or not. Because you're abroad with the kids doesn't stop your man from sending money. And if he's not doing it, please, my sister, ask him. Baba Lagbaje, please, we need money. Send it. You understand? But if you're living abroad and he's just sending him money, that one I go bail.
No, that one
I serious go bail. No. Except, you know, you can do it for some time, but that one is even another ball game. But wherever the man is living, he should still be sending money. He doesn't have to be asked. Even if it's £100 or $100 a month, darling, manage it. You know, it will make you feel good, won't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
You understand what I'm saying? So it doesn't matter where he is in the world, he should still be able to send money. No, and you don't really need to ask, but if he's not doing it, please ask. Yeah?
Okay. I'll chat with you inbox on Facebook.
Okay, fantastic. Thank you so much, sis. Thanks for calling in. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Right. That's another point. That's another valid point. The number again is 0203-355-5526. Did I get it right? Yeah, 0203-355-5526. I was asked this question a while ago as well. And It's still the same. We've got another caller online. What's your name and where are you calling from, please?
Hello, Adeshe.
Hello.
My name is Folake.
Huh?
Calling from London.
What's your name, please?
Folake.
Hello, Sister Folake. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Where we got to contribute?
Well, I'm not married.
Okay.
But I would like to contribute just a tiny bit.
Okay.
If someone is married and they feel single, mm-hmm. in that marriage.
Yes.
Maybe they feel single because the only one responsible.
Yeah.
Or marriage is not really working out.
Yeah.
Then you're better off being single.
Yes.
Because you should be in a marriage and be single.
Yes.
A marriage, it should be reciprocal. I mean, it's give and take.
Yes.
Both of you should be able to contribute.
Yes.
To make that marriage work.
Yes.
But if you're in a marriage and you're miserable.
Yeah.
And it's one-sided, then you're better off being on your own.
Yes. Yes. I think that's why many women feel like that, actually. That's why they feel like they're single, because they're the only one contributing for the upkeep of the home. And they get frustrated after a while that, look, what is this man doing? You understand? So, and as you just said, I say to women, if you feel single in your marriage, then maybe you shouldn't be there.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. So you're not married yet. You've got kids?
I've got two kids.
Yes.
I've been a single parent for a very long time.
Oh.
And
longer than me.
I am responsible.
Because I always think I'm the longest kids. Single parent living.
So I don't have to feel excited because I'm not with kids. So if I'm with somebody and I'm feeling single because I'm the only one responsible for paying bills or, you know, making the marriage work, then I'd rather be single.
Yes. Yeah.
So I don't feel be married and feeling single.
Yeah.
Marriage is for two people to work together, you know, and bring up a family. If you have children, you have to contribute.
Yes.
A man has to be responsible. A woman doesn't have to ask a man to pay bills, to be responsible for the children.
Yes.
Because if you can make it, anyone can make it. But it takes somebody responsible, a special person, to be a father.
Oh, yes.
So if a woman is in a marriage with a man, and she's one responsible paying the bills, doing everything, the man doesn't contribute, well, I would say kick him to the curb.
Yeah.
Yes. Because you know, also you spoke about cohabiting.
Yes.
If you're cohabiting with someone, eventually the person can walk out.
Yeah.
The person can behave any way they want. They can go around and say, "Sorry, I'm not married."
Yeah.
And even with a woman, you have children with a woman, and you're not ready to commit to marry that person.
Yes.
So you know it's. When you present yourself to a man, that's how he's going to treat you.
Yeah.
If you're with a man and you're not paying the bills from the beginning, then it's going to have to take and eat it.
Yes. True.
So, sometimes, you know, we ladies, we are the ones who is allowing this man.
Where the engineer.
The way they're treating us.
Yes.
We have to be strong. I mean, when you're a mother and you have daughters, what example you lay for your daughters?
Yes, that's true.
That, okay, I can be the one to pay the bills and the man can just fluff around.
Yes, yes.
So that's not good because a kid will see us doing that and they might end up making the same mistake.
Yes, that's true.
As a woman, you have to be strong.
That's true.
You have to make good examples for your children. You have to put your foot down and you have to make the man responsible. And the man doesn't want to be responsible.
Yes.
Then you have to call it a day and be on your own.
True. Oh, fantastic. Thank you so much, Sister Folake, for contributing that. Thank you so much. And
welcome.
I hope it goes well for you. You meet the right cuckoo master. Yeah, because this one that you said you've been too long for a single mother. Please leave that one. I pray for good cocoa master in the name of Jesus. Rabababa Shende Bobo. In the name of Jesus. Amen. God bless you. Hallelujah. Bye bye. That prayer must come to. Why are you laughing? I'm so stupid. Sometimes I get carried away too much. That is the cocoa here. Eh? That is the thing. That's the problem with women. We always give our men the chance to do whatever. If you start your relationship, it is only you taking on the bills and everything. We've got a caller online. Who is calling, please, and where are you calling from?
Hello.
Hello.
I'm calling from Manchester. For calling.
What's your name, please?
Sumbo.
Oh, Sister Sumbo, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you, my sister.
How you doing? Have you just woken up? Because that's bedroom voice you've got there.
Oh, that's my voice, anyway.
That's your voice. It seems you're doing something.
Thank you.
Okay. Oh, this is your voice. Ah, yeah, it's so bad. My dad is dead.
Like your
tell
topic
me
this
something.
On your wall.
Right. Are you married? I should ask you.
Yes.
You are married?
Yes.
Ah, okay, let me see that. Oh yeah, tell me your story. Are you
what
feel married?
If you say oh, because what happens to me in my past relationship?
Yes.
I won't marry again.
Eh?
No. It's not like that.
Okay.
It doesn't have to be like that.
Yes.
You don't stay because someone did something to you in the past.
Mm.
You don't want to settle down with. When you start apportioning blame, that is when you will be on your own.
Yes.
So we just have to, we women just, it's down. Because we also have our own fault. If you look back, you say, oh, maybe I did something wrong then.
Yeah.
So let me try to correct myself this.
Yes.
But when you start thinking, no, I won't take this, I won't take this, I won't take that.
Yes.
You won't be able to settle down.
That's true.
And one thing is this, if you live in Nigeria, fine. But in abroad, you will be on your own, you end up in your home. Yes. That's why.
Have you heard
we
don't have banyo? Serious matters.
We just have to forget the past.
Yeah.
Yes, exactly. Like,
but what can I just ask you, Sister Sumbo, right? You say that you're married, but you're married right now, right?
Yes.
Do you feel like you're, as if you're married, or you're feeling like a single mother, like a single person, even though you're married?
Let me tell you one thing. I was a single mother for, let me say, like 18 years.
You were 18, yes. You're a single mother for 18 years?
Yes.
Huh? God, I hope I don't have 8 years to go. I've just done 10
on
years.
On my own.
Huh?
Two of them are graduate. The other one is in the final year.
Okay.
You understand what I mean? My grown up three children. So, along the line, I said, oh, I did that because of what happened to me.
Yeah.
So that was why I was a bit late.
Okay.
My relationship now is 7 years.
You don't sound that old, though.
You say what?
You don't sound that old. You were single mother for 18 years. Your relationship now is 7 years. 25 years. If I look at your, that means you are in your 50s or.
Yeah. I'll be 50 this year.
Ah,
I started very early.
Ah, you sound really young though, right?
Oh, thank you for that.
Yeah, but so your marriage now, you're enjoying it, right?
Yes, I am. Because
yes, is the cocoa in
sometimes,
good?
Sometimes, let me say one thing. Sometimes,
she's not
something
asking
is best for you. Rather take.
Yeah.
If you don't take it, you end up miserable. Like, after with my baby's father, when I finished with him, I was with someone else.
Yeah.
But he was a woman.
He was a woman?
Womanizer.
Oh, womanizer.
You understand what I mean?
Yeah.
And that was what broke my first marriage.
Okay.
My first.
So is this your second marriage or your third marriage?
This is second one.
Okay, and it shall be permanent in Jesus' name.
Amen. I was I mean, I was with someone.
Yeah.
Thinking, oh, I'm going to marry this person.
Yes.
But along the line, I realized there would be a mistake on my part.
Right.
I decided to be my own and take care of my friends.
Right. Can I ask you something, right?
Yes.
You know this relationship, because you said that if somebody is trying to be like, oh, I want this, I want that, I want my marriage to be like this, that they will remain single for a very long time, right?
Yes.
So what, obviously, in your marriage now, you're working?
Yes.
And your husband is working?
Exactly.
So what's it, you've got any kids for each other, or you've just got kids
No.
from, you haven't?
We're taking care of the one we've got together.
Okay, so you just mix children together, that is the sort of relationship I like. Mix children
yes.
together.
Well, that, let me tell you about that issue of children.
Yes.
I left it so late because
yeah.
I was so wrapped up in my children's upbringing.
Mm.
Then when I met, I said, okay, I want to start now.
Mm.
I couldn't.
You couldn't? Wow.
Yeah, it was from one minute.
To the other.
I had to stop for my health.
Hmm.
I had to stop trying because of my health.
Right.
And thank God for that. You understand me very well that we are really good.
So how come you're not feeling single in your relationship, in your marriage now?
You know why I'm not, I don't feel single.
Why?
Before you know it, I was told, welcome back from work, morning, something like that. I share things with him. We discuss about our children together.
Okay.
We did things for our children together.
Right.
So, I don't take decisions on my own now about my children.
That's good.
I have someone to share with.
Oh, great.
Just how I mean.
Is that down to experience? Is that down to experience, what you've got now?
Yes, exactly.
Right, exactly. Fantastic. That's good. Thank you so much, Sister Bay Sumba, for contributing that much. And keep the cocoaing going, yeah?
Okay.
And no babies, no babies. Keep it like that. No babies.
I won't.
Just mix children together like that, and we mix
stuff,
and you bake cake. All right, then. Thank you so much.
Okay.
Love you.
Bye-bye.
Wow, that's a good one. She's enjoying her relationship, you know. 7 years, even though she was a single mother for 18 years. But that scared me because now I've been single mother for 10 years. She said 18 years. Father Lord, I beg you, show me mercy. I don't want to go another 8 years. I will go mental. It is not easy. Ooh, let me leave that one anyway. The Coco, we got another caller online. Hello, caller. What's your name? Hello. Gone? We've missed the call. The truth is, you know, just like she said now, our relationship is going really well. She doesn't feel like a single person. They talk about things. I think in a relationship where you're married and you're still feeling single, I think it's more down to the communication aspect of it. Sometimes when I talk to my Coco Master, we can talk for about 2-3 hours, right? But at the end of the day, one day I came to realize that we always talk about things happening around us. We don't talk about us, me and him. We don't talk about it. So when you're married and you're feeling single, obviously, you know, your communication is outside of your marriage. You're not talking, you're not being friends, which you really need to be. And that's another point that last caller made. She said they talk when they get back from work. They talk, they discuss, they do things, which is very, very important in a relationship. You must talk about everything to do with the two of you. Don't only sit down and start talking about kids, about bills. Oh, me and my partner, we used to argue about these bills. One day, I said, you know what? This your bills talk is driving me nuts. She said, oh, really? Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't. I just say it because I'm talking to you. In your relationship, put bills aside. I know you're going to talk about bills, but don't make it like the center point of your relationship. Don't make it to drag on and on and on and on and on. I know these bills has got to be paid, but women, men, come on. If you start well, you won't have to be discussing bills every day. Your gumshoe, your brain, your common sense should tell you we're going to pay bills anyway. You know the lights aren't free, the gas aren't free. In UK, water is not free. There's no conga in London, no borehole in London. We pay for water. If you don't pay for water, fine. Me, I pay for water anyway. The only thing I don't pay is TV license, you know. But at the end of the day, I pay for water. Yeah? But the truth is, you must discuss. You must communicate. You must do that. You have to. Oh, I shouldn't say I don't pay TV license. Because I don't watch my TV. I've got old TV. It's over 10 years old. And it doesn't come on anyway. So, I don't pay TV license. Yes, I don't pay TV license because I don't watch TV in my house. I have old banger TV and it doesn't work. Yes. Okay. Anyway. You should know these things. So, what's the problem? If you're feeling single when you're married, then there's a problem in that relationship. And you're still having sex. You're still sleeping together. That is even worse. You can't just be sleeping with me when I'm not connecting with you. It is a silly move. Right? You see your man coming up to you. I know in German, they always do shakara when they want to, you know, especially those ones that don't do foreplay, right? The typical Naija man will just zoom like that. And next thing you see their hand, bosa, on your chest. Oh my days. They will just go, bam, and you just feel this bang on your chest if you have the woman. And by the time you look at it, it's off your putu, it's off your everything, and marathon starts. Boo, 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 boo. You just see the man snoring next to you. Naija men, you're not sometimes. But if you're in a relationship, stop looking at me like that. If you're married, and that is the sort of parole that goes on in your relationship, hell no. Don't even take it. Talk to your man. Man, talk to your woman. If you're a man, because men are in abusive relationship as well, you know. They're in a relationship that they don't feel loved. If they talk, I've got a friend. Her name is Nikki. Yes. She said to me, she's married though. She said, anything, just let's do pa pa pa. I said, what do you mean, just let's do pa pa pa? She said, which one is pa 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 pa? Kissing, kissing, touching, touching, touching. I know some women are like that. You kiss them, it's wahala. You touch them, it's bilisi. You think nothing. They just log of wood. I used to be like that as well, though. I won't lie. But if you're a woman like that, your man will feel single even though he's married to you. We women always believe we're the only one that feels single in a relationship. No, men do feel single as well, even though they're married or they're living with us. They still feel single because we don't communicate. We don't come up with right conversations. We always come up with nagging things, you know. And especially women that knows how to cook, they can kill a man with food. All they will give that man is food. They won't give the man cocoa. They're not good in other areas, though. You know, they may not be good. Don't let me say they're not good. They may not be good in other areas. No, don't let me use the word good. They may not like try to improve other skills in their relationship, like conversation skills, communication skills, dressing skills. Because men do feel single. If they see you dressing up like one old mama that's in the village, they will feel single because they can see different things out there. And you see so many women walking around the house with Shirley on their faces in the morning. I cannot stand them. Morning time. Why walking out with Shirley on your face? Come on, clear it. It's morning time. You understand what I'm saying? How do you wake your husband up in the morning? I won't get up my bed if my man is sleeping next to me without giving him a kiss. Things like that will jazz up your relationship. It will make it, you know, you won't feel single anymore. All our own single is all about money, money, money. No, it shouldn't be. Yeah? How do you look after the kids? Share it. We're not like in Nigeria that we've got housemaid or whatever. No, we haven't got that here. Okay, some people, they've got au pairs, but you can share it. You can communicate, you can discuss about it and say, okay, this kid is business, how are we gonna do it? But if you've been doing it on your own before, you can't just bring it upon him. It's not possible. Now, okay, I'm hoping to get married one day if I meet Mr. Right that's gonna marry me with my stinky attitude. But at the end of the day, you know, we'll have to talk about it. We've got a caller online. What's your name and where you calling from, please?
Apostle Kufurona.
Huh?
Apostle Kufurona from Lagos.
Apostle?
Kufurona from Lagos.
Apostle Kufurona from Lagos.
Right.
Okay, right. What have you got to contribute, sir?
Well, I've got a topic about living together. But sometimes it is easier to live together with a wife without commitment, without... It's cheaper to be with them, to live with together, than to divorce.
Where? In Nigeria?
No, in US.
Oh, it's cheaper?
Mm-hmm. Because if you live together, even though you're not doing anything, you know, you live together, you marry together, whoever you are married, you live together. You have to pay child support, you have to do this. And then some females are very, very vindictive. So because you're not living with them anymore, they will make your life a miserable hell.
Yeah.
So sometimes it's a lot easier for you to find a girlfriend outside and just live at home.
Apostle Kufurona, I shall
they'll take you. So they'll take you in. They'll take you in for child support, emotional support. Take everything that you have.
Yes.
Have nothing. They'll pretty much trip you naked.
Right.
So then you just that just need to be as a roommate. I think you have a peace of mind. You can have a girlfriend outside and do whatever you want to do.
Even though you're living
most
together.
Of a financial reason. And it is financial reason.
Oh.
Because you can be sharing the cost of living. That you'll be living on to be pay for your own house and separately and keep it for our family. I think the two can still get along. You gotta be cooking each other.
Yeah.
You gotta find someone outside to be cooking.
Yeah, but hold on. If you're living together under the same roof, right?
Mm-hmm.
Why should things get that far before you go, you know, you go your separate ways?
Just cheaper to be, the same, the cheaper to keep than to lose.
Is it?
Cheaper to keep the wife than to lose the wife. Because when you lose your wife, it costs too much money.
Oh, so you'd rather be together.
It can financially ruin you.
Okay.
Look at Tiger Woods. You know, when he lost his wife, he saw how much money he lost.
Oh. So are you married?
Michael Jordan. Say it again.
Are you married?
No, I'm not married.
You're not married. Are you living with someone?
No, I'm living by myself.
You're living by yourself. Okay, so,
right.
But have you ever been married?
Yes, I've been.
You've been married before. So, did you ever live like when you were married, did you ever live like a single person? Did you feel did you feel like you were single when you were married?
Yes.
Oh, why?
Yeah, that's why I got out of married. That's why I got out of the marriage. That's me.
But so, I'm even though you were married, you felt like a single person?
Right, because sometimes when the marriage is not working out, when something is not working out, you have no communication.
Yeah.
And sometimes it's a lot easier for you to do your own thing than to be arguing with your wife just about every second. Or to just be nagging.
Yeah.
Because sometimes some people can be very nagging, just nagging and just be, you know, just be, I can't use the right word to say, but sometimes it's better to be a keep.
Right.
You just have to do your own thing, stay in your own corner, everybody stay in their own corner, and you have to cook with each other, do whatever you have to do, and
That's not going to be really nice. That's going to be a bad atmosphere.
Say again, please.
That's going to be a bad atmosphere. If you're doing your own thing and the woman is doing her own thing, it's not going to be a nice place. It's not going to be conducive.
It's not married. When you get to that point, you don't be married anymore. It's just the financial reason why you are there. Whether you are there because of the children or financial reason. And okay. As I said earlier, I used to be in the U.S. before. I moved back to Nigeria because of my wife.
Okay.
That's why I moved back to Nigeria. So, because she was just moved to Nigeria and stay in America. So if I stay in America, I'd be paying child support, I'd be paying, for example, if I left my wife, my paycheck was $59 every 2 weeks. Before I received my paycheck, I just took 35% off for child support out of it.
Yeah.
So, that are there,
yeah.
So out of my $100, I'm only at 50.
Yeah.
And so the wife only collects 70 based on more. So yeah, that's what I'm doing just from being her. But if I stay with her and just mind the position than with her in the same house,
yeah.
I'll be considered $100.
Yeah, but if you're living in Nigeria and you're married in Nigeria, you'll be taking out the whole of the responsibilities anyway.
But in Nigeria, if you take tired of her, if the money is not worth off with, no government is going to make it her anything you feel like you're supposed to do with her.
Yeah.
You see what I said? I'm married wife in Nigeria, if I'm married in Nigeria, my house is my house. If money doesn't work out, the wife is just walking away.
Then the woman can go away.
My house is my house, I can't back up.
So.
Empty said the house belongs to me. It goes back to our family house. Empty-handed, just when she came back.
Can you imagine? You're a selfish man.
But America, there's a different story. It's the workout.
Yeah? Oh, gosh.
The wife keeps the house, the car, the money, the everything.
Yeah?
And the government will tell you
go.
That the wife has the right, that you walk away. So it's opposite direction. In Nigeria, the husband keeps everything, the wife go back.
Mm-hmm.
In America, the wife keeps everything.
Everything. So that's why you didn't run
it. And that's the reason why I'm not Nigerian overseas. Leaves at home with a wife at room.
Unhappy.
But she was a kid that could lose.
Interesting. Oh, that's interesting. Thank you so much, Apostle Foworola from Lagos. Thank you for adding that. That's a good insight. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Talk to you again soon. Bye-bye. Wow. Convenient marriage, that's what I call that, because at the end of the day, if it's convenient because of financial reasons or because of kids, then obviously you can have a loggerhead relationship, because there's no love there anymore. You're living together, you don't want to lose things, then you stay there. Do you have that patience? I don't think so. When I walked away from my marriage, you know what, I left him with the house. I left him with everything. Me, I don't have patience that much. I don't. I just say, Mister, take the house. I give you je. I went to go and rent one bedroom flat with my Pekin Benito. I don't like stress. When it comes to things like that, I run. I don't have to struggle with money or with people. I just go. And I always tell people, if you're in a marriage or relationship, you know it's not going to work. You know the truth yourself. Let it go. It doesn't work. You being in a relationship because of financial reasons, especially here abroad, some people will... I know a guy that stayed with a woman for 10 years. Right? 10 years. The guy was taking contraception. Contraceptive or what did they do, so that he wouldn't be able to impregnate the woman or the lady because of papers. The woman, they tried for 10 years, the woman didn't get pregnant. She didn't know that the man was taking pills, was taking something so that he wouldn't have his sperm wouldn't, you know. Some people do terrible things because they want to stay together, because they want something. Marriage is not for you to be enduring it by fire, by force. No, it doesn't work like that. It doesn't make sense. You got a problem in your relationship, talk about it. That's the whole point of it. Talk about it. We'll soon be finishing now. We've only got a few more minutes to go, about 5 minutes. But the truth of the cocoa of the truth today is this. If you're in a marriage, relationship, and it's not working, talk about it. Talk about it. It is good to talk. It is good to communicate. The last caller, he said, okay, in America, it's cheaper for you to remain in a marriage than to break up because you will lose everything as a man. Do I want everything from my ex? No, because I want my peace. You need to learn as a woman, as a man, you know, how to be peaceful within yourself. Your inner peace is what will work for you and will make your children to be beautiful and be happy. There's no point in you struggling in a relationship. Your relationship is to be enjoyed, not to be, you know, in loggerheads and fighting one another like a mad cat and dog. Telephone lines are now closed. It's very easy to fall into a pattern in a relationship whereby you'll be managing things. It's very, very easy. You go through the same routine day in, day out. All in the name of, I don't want it to break. I don't want it to break. Where am I going to start from? Does it really worth it? Do you really need to go that far? I don't think so. If you cannot talk with your partner and let him or her know how you feel or how you're feeling, then you shouldn't be there. I don't like divorce. I've been through it. And I wouldn't wish it even on my enemy. But it doesn't work. You staying in a relationship because you don't know where to start from, because of the kids, because of finances, because of papers, it doesn't worth it. The least, the best you can do for yourself is to make yourself happy in that relationship. Be truthful to yourself. I've got a problem with women. Because it's us mainly to complain about relationship, about marriage, about not being happy in our marriages. And the problem I've got with us is this. We don't talk. We believe our men should be a psychic. We believe they should know things. No. Tell them. Honey, I don't like what you're doing. Honey, can we change this, please? Honey, I don't like the way you're cocooing me. I like doggy style. I like 69. I like whatever style. Talk about it. Right? My producer is saying he likes fingering. Maybe that's what he told his wife. Who knows? And he said Caesar style. Don't confuse me. Anyway, rounding up now. This is the truth again. Talk about things. And if you know you don't want to be there, don't be there. Your heart must be in whatever you're doing. That is when you get the peace and joy. If your heart is not there, then don't bother to do it. You see some women in the name of their man cheating, then they're thinking, well, he's doing it, let me do it. Don't even go there. It doesn't worth it. Thank you so much for tuning in today. This is Abefe Badera. We've just tuned into www.fusionplustv.com. If you need to contact me, my number is 075-068-11309. And my email is help@abefebadera.com or abefebadera@yahoo.com. You don't really need to be miserable when you can be at peace with everyone. Even in your relationship. Enjoy your evening and see you next time. Good night.